Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the AD2L season number 12. We've got the meme regime here up against Treehead's Wiener Mash. Definitely an interesting name right there. And we'll see how they manage to play this game. So as we are here, let's introduce our players real quick. We might need to turn this up a little bit. All right, there we go. All right, so let's introduce our teams here. We've got Zeus, played by Sly Fox. It's going to be Tar Palantir. That's going to be playing the Lich. Razor will be handled by Treehead, the namesake of Treehead's Wiener Mash. We've got Big Gigantic. He's going to be playing the Sven. And then finally, Disruptor will be handled by Wiener, the one who's being mashed. For the meme regime this time, it's going to be G playing the Lion. Zing will be handling the Drow Ranger, Passion on the Invoker, one of the only heroes that he can play. Kim Jong-il, or Peter, he'll be playing the Outer Titan, and then it's going to be Mister on the offlane Weaver. A little bit of a greedy hero for them, and I'm not entirely sure how well the Weaver will do up against the Disruptor, but he does manage to pick up the Bounty Rune right off the bat, so they weren't able to put enough bodies on top of it to stop Mister from picking it up, so both Bounty Runes will go to the Radiant side. So they just kind of contacted me to cast this match. I don't know why. Apparently they wanted someone to watch them though. So hopefully the meme regime managed not to feed this match, but I really highly doubt that they won't do that. I believe we were going to see a bunch of feeding from them, but we are generally used to them not doing well, so it wouldn't really be any surprise. Passion against Zeus in the mid lane. It's just kind of sitting here. Zeus, I think, should do okay against this. He doesn't really do too much damage to the Forge Spirits, which is really what's going to stop the Invoker from winning this lane. But, yeah, he should still be fine. And Zeus even manages to get a deny off over the Invoker. It's kind of weird since Invoker has so much damage due to the Drow Aura. He really doesn't have to worry too much, and well, Mister's getting a little bit aggressive on the Wiener. Always has to be aware that Sven could just level up and stun him at any moment. And there is a ton of the damage that Weaver really does not want to take at this point, but with the Drow Aura, he really doesn't have to be too careful at all. Hitting for 71 per hit, and remember that he also has a Geminate Swarm as well. That's quite unfortunate. Bottom. Treehead's getting a little bit aggressive. Interesting that they would put a Razor against a Drow. And he's just going to sit here on the other side of the trees. And Razor's going to steal some damage from him. Gets a little bit of a block from the creep. But he is stolen a lot of damage. And Kim Jong-il is going to chase after him. Perhaps we see the first blood. He's still going to continue to be slowed down. And it's going to take a little bit more than that. Zingle goes around the trees. And Kim Jong-il! I am kind of glad that I sponsored that guy, because he has managed to pick up the first blood here. Picks up level 2. Also gets a stun on this Tar Palantir. Nothing much comes out of that, though. And they're really not doing too much to fight the Weaver here. They went for the dual lane setup, which kind of helps him out a little bit. I mean, you are going to get a bunch of levels against him, but it's not 3 heroes that he's going to have to play against. It's only 2, which really helps the Weaver quite a bit. And they're going to put the Sentry Ward down. They also have the... No, they don't have the Glimpse just yet, just the Kinetic Field. I would feel like a Glimpse is a pretty good tool against a Weaver, but they like not to level it up so early. Drow puts a couple more slows in the lane here. G is going to get a lot of damage stolen from him by the Razor. And they really don't want to wait too long in this. Like, Razor's just going to turn around and probably get a kill on the G right now. But he's actually going to have to go through the creeps quite a bit. And they're slowing him down. Kim Jong-il does quite a bit of damage with his staple gun. And he'll also put the Spirit out there once more. But he's just gone a bit too far away. And Mister's gotten stunned. He'll go into his Shikuchi, but he's on very low health right now, and he has gone down. 2 kills on the offlane, 1 for the Radiant. So both lanes are going to be a little bit of bloodshed there. But it's kind of to be expected at this point. Like, Weaver isn't as adept at staying alive in the offlane. But, you know, he should be fine. Not really sure what all the shit talk going on here is. is under attack. Wiener doesn't really seem too happy to be so low. And Mister can kind of use this opportunity to put some harass on Sven. And maybe make it a lot less safe to stay in that lane. Alright, so Disruptor, he's going to try to get back into the match. He's having a little bit of lag, and hopefully he's back soon. Hopefully it's not a lasting problem. I would definitely like to see a good match between these two teams. So far, in terms of the lanes, we've got Invoker leading the last hit so far. Single's doing okay bottom, I guess, but he really needs to get his last hitting game on. He does have a kill, and it's an assist, and two denies. So he's not doing too terribly right now, but when you're going for all those kills, sometimes it's a little bit difficult to make sure that you're getting all the CS that you need. But he is being active right now, so I guess we'll give him the benefit of the doubt. I'm sure that's something that Zingo isn't really used to getting, but yeah, it's just so difficult for him to get his CS right now. I mean, even with 77 damage, he's got a Lich trying to get him down. There's a Raze that does 53 damage per hit, or thereabouts. So it's really difficult for the Drow Ranger right now. And the lane's just pushed up so far right now that it's tough for her to get any last hits that aren't under tower. Kim Jong-il, Peter, he's rotated over towards the mid lane. He steps up a little bit, and that's probably going to be the Elder Titan's time to get in. He's still out of vision right now. Just waiting for the Zeus to step up a little bit more. He doesn't want to miss his opportunity right now. And over at top, we've got a Kinetic Field drop down. Mister, he's underneath the Sentry Ward, and he's just going to try to get away, but he's not been able to. And Zeus ranges over. Still doesn't see the Elder Titan on the high ground. Radiance top tower. And I'm just waiting for this guy to come in here, and he actually is just going to walk underneath tower and kind of waste his opportunity there. He'll also kind of bait him in with the stomp, but there just wasn't any damage there. Radiance top tower is under attack. Yeah, so the early advantage did go a little bit the way of Meme Regime, but now their rotations aren't really doing too much. And they're just not able to do enough with what they have on the map right now. I think that the Weaver should be fine right now, taking two deaths right now, and doesn't have the best comeback mechanic, but not having wards here in this lane has really hurt him quite a bit, and Weaver, an offlane Weaver, you really don't want to give it any help early. And it's gotten to the point where he's had to be extremely careful of this Sven walking around. Elder Titan, I mean, he rotated over to the mid lane, but I would probably like to see him get a little bit more bottom. Razor, he's leveled up the plasma field up to 2. He's put another Frost Blast on the G, which still has pretty good mana after that. Another sacrifice in 21 and has another Frost Blast right now. And Lion's just going to suck some mana away from Treehead, make it so he doesn't have enough to cast too many spells. But with the Ring of Epicilius, he should be pretty fine at getting that mana back. Still, bunch of heroes just kind of sitting on the map, looking for places where they can just hang out, maybe get some kills. Weaver has to be extremely careful. This is kind of the problem of having a hero that isn't so good at lane control. I mean, the lane's getting back there right now, and it's going to keep going back. Ooh, over at bottom, we've got a stomp coming in on the tar. And Mr. Treehead. Yeah, Treehead's trying to get out. Zingle's going to continue to do some good damage. He's going to put it out of his link, and Zingle's going to have to be very careful. Silence is Treehead, but the stun is going to be off the mark, and Zingle's taking a lot of damage from this. Maybe the Thunderbolt. Yeah, the Thunderbolt is able to clean it up. Stomp is off the mark. So a Draw Ranger, a pretty big kill. Yeah, Sunstrike off the mark in the mid lane. Yeah, Zingle's a pretty big kill for Treehead's Wiener Mash, but before that happened, there were two different kills that went towards her, so I don't think the kill is too terribly bad this early into the game. I think she's probably gaining more than she loses there. And Peter's got a double damage rune here. He is going to get scouted out a little bit when he gets closer to the lane. And they're also going to see the lion there, so they should know this. But they see Kim Jong-il a little bit late. He still gets hit with the plasma field. So being on such low health, it means that he does have to back away. And Treehead manages to steal 14 damage before the Drow Ranger gets out of range. This tri lane is probably going to benefit Treehead's Wiener Mash a little bit more. Shut down the farm of Zingle just a bit more. At least until he gets to level 6. And Invokers, he's taken a kill on Zeus in the mid lane right after he gets his minus. That's pretty good. Like, even after you've gone for the minus, you're still able to get a kill. That's actually huge for an Invoker. And you really want to get those kills going. Mostly to get the money for Midas. But in any case, Kim Jong-il nearly down in the finger. Actually ends up finishing off the Razor. A huge kill for them. And Tartar, he tries to put one more Frost Blast, but it's not going to matter. G thinking about going over towards Wiener, but Sly Fox has made his way down to the bottom lane. Okay, Lion's just hanging out there a little bit more. Drow throws out the silence on Sly Fox, but doesn't really want to be there too much. And well, Lion's able to even find the kill on Disruptor inside the Roche Pit. Zeus actually is able to use entire combo on G to finish him off there, but I think Lion's excessively happy with that. He's managed to get a kill. He hasn't managed to spend his gold, but he is getting very close to a Blink Dagger. And that's going to be a very quick Blink Dagger for Lion. Already on Tranquil Boots, and that was 1,500 gold. Now he's bought a couple of wards. But, I mean, he's very close to his Blink Dagger so early in the game. That will be devastating for Treehead's Wiener Mash if he gets there so early. And they're definitely not going to be expecting it. Wiener's ready on the top lane. He's got two levels into Glimpse. Could hit onto the Weaver, who steps up a little bit in lane. Perhaps this would be their opportunity to get the Glimpse back in the stun, but also, Disruptor has a fairly quick 6 as well to get a silence on Weaver, so the Weaver really can't be at this lane. In fact, if he steps up even more, he's definitely going to be feeling some hurt pretty soon. But as we say that, rotation over to the mid lane, they're going for the wraparound on Sly Fox. Razor's taking a lot of damage from the Elder Titan illusion. He's just sapped that up with the link, and here comes G. He's walking fast. He's got the stun. He'll turn Sly Fox into a fish, and he's going to get the stun as well. Kim Jong-il's ready. They've got the stomp. They've got the sunstrike, and the stomp is enough to finish him off. Meanwhile, in the top lane, they're going to get a silence on Mister, but he's managed to Shikuchi away from the Static Storm. He can't really stay there too long, and Big Gigantic. He's just going to go right after him. The tower is going to get destroyed, but maybe Mister decides to go in on this. It would be an excessively bad idea, especially since there is a sentry ward there. At least the tower gets taken down. In any case, the game will continue. First tower of the game. It's taken for, well, it was the Radiant side because they took the one in mid. May see a rotation at bottom. Zingle's getting scouted out here. He just wants that last creep. Doesn't hit the last hit anyway. And Wiener, he's got him, but he missed the silence. Zingle, he's going to go right for Wiener, slowing him down a little bit. And he puts down the kinetic field. Is it going to be enough? No. Zingle still manages to get the kill. And also tower in the top lane is taking a lot of damage from this. Zingle, he just is the one person out there. Sunstrike, yeah, it's going to hit the stomp. Gigantic manages to evade it, but he doesn't manage to evade the finger, and he's got so much going after him right now. He's got the bug on his butt, and the bug on his butt just ends up killing him. Anyway, next tower goes the way of Meme Regime, and remember, Zingle's still pushing bottom, level 8, nearly 9 right now. I don't even think this push top is going to stop anytime soon. Maybe they lose Zingle here. He steps into the stack, into the plasma field, and even takes a little bit more damage from the tower, but he's really not scared of this at all. And he's just going to go right in. Silences the Razor, but he's underneath tower, doesn't want to be there for too long. Witch is here, and he's got his Chain Frost available. It's going to go around all the creeps. He's just cast it right there. Still manages to kill the lion, and Zingle just has to remember not to go too far up there. Sly Fox, oh, he needs to get away right now. The lightning bolt off the target. And the stomp doesn't manage to hit, only onto the creeps to stop the push. Meanwhile, at top, Invoker's doing some pretty massive damage to the tier 2 tower, and they're going to have to go in on this sometime. Wiener is ready with the Sack Storm, and maybe a glimpse as well, but he's going to turn around with the cold snap. Wiener's going to die for it, throws out the Definitely Blast as well, but Slyfox and Big Gigantic are here, so Passion will pay for that with his life, and there are going to be no returns on that deal as well. So still a lot of lag issues for Treehead's Wiener Mash. I believe they are playing from, I think, Arizona. So anyway. Anyway, I am casting, guys. Anyway, I didn't do anything. I know how to stream, guys. Come on. Thank you for the host, by the way, Miss Ultimate Cannon. Always appreciate when you non-Dota knowing guys come out here and watch the stream. It really means a lot to me. Even if you have no idea what's going on. Ah, man. Zingle looking for a kill on bottom. I don't know if he's going to be able to get it. He's going to keep going forward, which I don't... He needs to hide in the vision, but he just wasn't able to work with it. And Disruptor comes in, but not with a glimpse because he's on cooldown for another 7 seconds. In any case... What's funny is I actually casted this team before. This Treehead's Wiener match. I casted them against Game Sense Boys. You would think that I wouldn't remember that because it was kind of a one-off thing. I think it was in JDL as well. But I would kind of remember a name like that. Oh look, Passion's feeding a couple of Forge Spirits over to Slyfox. Says here you can have a little bit of gold, make you a little bit happier. He's going for the Veil of Discord build up right now. It's definitely a great item on Zeus, especially if your team is a little bit behind, which Meme Regime, they are a little bit behind right now. Illusion. See, it's weird. I don't really know why you would say if someone's stream cheating unless they're, like, dewarding you very early. Oh, Giga goes for it, and that's the Blink Dagger. It's an easy kill on Sly Fox, and that's definitely the reason he's going for something like a Veil of Discord, just because this game is going to end very quickly if he doesn't get some damage soon. So Zangle picks up the Dragon Lance, and this is with the Blink Dagger on Lion and the Dragon Lance. They're just going to put the Static Storm right now. They don't want to get hit by this Fen. Fen coming in, has a stun available, and he's going to throw it out. Nice hit on the G, and the Chain Frost going all over the place means that, yeah, Passion's going to take some damage from it. Has to split up from his Forge Spirits, so Treehead's Wiener Mash, they come back in even without the Zeus ultimate and manage to find a kill on Lion, but it's only a support going down, and all of the personnel for Tree, for the Meme Machine right now, they've got everything they need. Weaver doesn't want to go too far underneath that Sentry Ward. And TWM, they've been very good with just knowing when to put their vision down. Zangle gets stunned out, and he's going to get the silence. Is he going to be able to deny himself? No, you cannot run from heaven! Zeus just cuts him down. Invoker's still doing pretty well with his build right now, and Razor might be a little bit far up. It's going to be a Yule Scepter up into the sky. He has gotten hit by that Purge a little bit, but the Stomp, the Stun, and oh, he's even going to drop the Split Earth for it. Wow, he hit Creeps! In any case, the push still continues bottom for Treehead's Wiener Mash. I will say that was a bit much for a kill on Razor, but they did want to make sure that he goes down. Razor, a pretty big part of making sure that TWM managed to have a good early game here. The Fortify is going to be down for the Radiant right now, and well, there is a G walking in, and he probably doesn't want to blink in too much in here. Oh, but he does hit the stun onto Lich. His Mia Sunstrike turns him to a fish. He can't move too far away from that, and he's going to get the Buckler buff to help him get away as well. Zangle just trying to slow a couple of heroes down. Big Gigantic looking for his play in here. He's going for the Yasha build up, so that might be a Sanjin Yasha from him. Interesting build up. I guess it's good if you're behind early. Zangle's taking a lot of damage from it. He just needs some heals and health right now. And he's going to get glimpsed back, but it's not far enough to really make a difference. And Cold Snap hits on the Sly Fox. There's going to be a Kinetic Field thrown out. There's going to be a stun. It hits this time on the three. They weren't hitting the best stuns before, but this time they do. Sunstrike hits onto a bunch of creeps. Wiener just steps up, but he's into the wrong place. He's going to get the Static Storm down. Zangle almost steps into it to die, but ends up not doing that. Mister goes back into the Static Storm. He's going to have a Shikuchi up, and Mister has to be careful. The Stomp actually hits on the two, and a double stun from G. He's hit it this time. Big Gigantic. He's dead. Oh, whoa. The Chain Frost got a runner away from that one, and Passion might get chased down by it, but the creeps are just going to keep it. This time getting a little bit lucky there, and it's not even killed the creep wave, which will continue to push in here. But that's a 2,000 gold change the way of the Meme Machine, and look at them. They go right into the Roche Pit. They're all going to ping. Oh, no. They have to be careful because one slam could actually take Mr. down at this point, and he's still just taking so much damage from it. He's going to get an urn. They're going to use Kim Jong-il to tank it up, and right now, Treehead's Wiener Mash, they can't do anything about this. It's just too late for them, and the Aegis goes to Passion. He's been having a little bit of a trouble with positioning these days, and picking up that Aegis ensures that he's going to get his combo off in the team fights. Also, that the Meme Machine might be able to reinitiate off of his death. That would probably be a good time to look at the overview of the items and the net worth in gold leads. 5,000 for XP in favor of the Meme Machine, and 7,500 for net worth. Couple of Forge Spirits go over to mid, but right now they just don't do damage with Drow Ranger, but just that combo going around the map does so much. And Zangle's even pushing on bottom. Look at this, they only have two heroes here. There's Invoker on mid, Weaver's at top, and Zangle just really doesn't care at all, which is gonna just take the crease behind the tower. And they stop a little bit with the damage. G, going pretty deep behind enemy lines with the smoke, puts a ward on the high ground. And he's going to hide a little bit inside the jungle. He's not in too much danger. Remember that he still has the Blink Dagger. They might think about going towards Sly Fox right now, but there is going to be a Razor with him. He's going to step in. He'll get the finger, and Tree has been killed with the Sunstrike. Lion's still going to get killed by Invoker by using that ultimate, and well, Zangle's found Wiener, but he has to go around the trees. He's not within range of the Disruptor there. And they can just take this tier 2 tower down. Still pushing despite the Lion being dead, not really caring that they don't have a stun here. has fallen. And they can rotate over towards bottom. Remember, they still have the Aegis on Invoker. And just surprisingly, the Weaver still hasn't gotten to an actual item right now. Just Power Treads and Urn. Urn Weaver, interesting build up there, but he should be finishing his Desolator fairly soon, and that will make that make it so that the towers go down a little bit quicker.
Dire's bottom tower has fallen.
So we just keep pushing in here. That's 5 towers taken for the meme regime right now, and the Fortify is not going to be available for another 4 minutes. And Treehead's Wiener Match, they go for a smoke. They want to go up the high ground, possibly catch up to Zingle. That would be a great kill for them. But Zingle always stepped up. He's in the wrong position right now. He's going to Hurricane Pike himself away. But yeah, Sven just blinks right towards him. He's even going to use the God Strength for it. Nearly pushed up to the high ground. That would have been devastating. But Zingle, he's just surrounded by everybody. Split Earth, not going to be enough to stop anything. But Weaver still manages to take the top tower. And that will be nearly enough gold. That's about 300 gold away from the Desolator. And he's only managed to get one last hit there. Now we've had the Aegis being popped on Invoker. Let's see if the rest of the team is able to do anything off the end of it. They're going to need a big stomp from the... Oh, that used to be an Utter Titan. Passion, he's going to get hit a little bit here. Tries to use a Cold Snap on the Razor, but it's not going to be nearly enough. And Weaver, he's going back to the base. Probably could have been pushing the base at that point, but decided that maybe he needed to help his team a little bit. And, well, this gives Treehead's Wiener Mash a little bit of an entry back into this game. They can defend their top tower. They've gotten a lot of kills off of that. We can see the gold change going back a little bit in favor of them. But it's not going to be too massive right now. It's still early in the game. And an Ags picked up on Invoker. Now we go back over to Med Big Gigantic. He's going in here. He's going in on the tower. A silence used on the backside. Wiener, he's been caught out. They're going to throw out the Chain Frost. They can't be too close together. Finger's just going to finish off the Disruptor. But these heroes are still grouping up. They are right next to the Creep Wave, but it's done a ton of damage to them. That's going to be Zingle taking a lot of damage from Zeus. Zeus, he's been stunned. They're going to slow bed take down. And Weaver has joined the fray. Silence hits onto the Sven. And Zeus going around the side. But Lion might be there. He needs a stun. He needs something. But they're just going to throw out the Spear. And Drow Ranger did manage to take the Sven. Excellent at kiting him. That's 4 deaths on the mid lane. And Lion, he's found the creep wave. They're going to still keep pushing here. And they've got our creep wave rushing up. Jeez. It's a little bit late for me. I'm not really into this too much. But still a lot of fun to cast. Oh! Passion just takes that iron branch out of the game. Man, that's just relentless there.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
So we're going to go for the tower right now. Treehead push out the plasma field. And Drow is hitting the tower from a ways away. They've got the Desolator going. That's just a ton of damage on the tower right now. It's getting his armor decreased. Wiener's going to be hit by the silence. And they just want to keep putting the Desolator damage onto the melee Rexes. This might be the first Rex of the game at 23 minutes for the meme machine. Mister has taken a lot of damage from that. Remember, he's still got the urn to put himself back up. But the entire Earth Splitter is going to miss. And the stomp, it only hits on the Wiener. There's going to be a TP in from Zeus. Kim Jong-il is very far up. He's going to be taking so much damage here, and he's just going to run right in. But Sly Fox, he's got himself caught out. Sven, he's ready. He wants to get the stun. He's on the Mr. and G. G and Mr. He needs to get that time walk, the time lapse off, but it's not enough because he's right underneath the ward. Big Gigantic, stunned up. He's hit by the meter, but he's not going to burn down enough. Also, Zingle continues to do so much damage with the Drow Ranger, and they cannot go for her at all. Big Gigantic is so low, blinks back towards the base. The Sunstrike off the mark. He knew that Sunstrike could have been coming, so he took a little bit of a weird path back to base, but I think Zingle's ready to go back in. Misses the silence, forces himself in, but there's just no one there for him to hit. And he's going for the Aghanims right now. Anyway, still the item builds continue for the meme regime, as well as a little bit on Treehead's Wiener Mash. They do have, I mean, they're still trying to get the Sanjin Yasha on Sven. I mean, that's still an item that's not going to do anything to get you back into the game. Like, you pick up a Sanjin Yasha on Sven, that's really an end the game early type of thing. Maybe it makes you a bit more survivable, but he's still going to have problems. I would much rather see him go for something like an Echo Saber. It could have killed those heroes a lot quicker. Definitely taking the Lion down over at this fight. so that he wouldn't have been able to get away. If he picks up the Echo Saber, it's... it's still, like, you get a lot more benefits from it. You still get the survivability. And it costs a lot less than building up a Sanji and Yasha. Like, Yasha build up on it right away doesn't make too much sense to me. It used to be the build on Sven, but with the addition of Echo Saber into the game, it doesn't make as much sense to me. Ooh, did I not have open mic on the whole time? I should probably change that. In any case. Yeah, right now it's just a little bit tough. It was nice that invokers build up the Yules. Generally, that's an item that the Elder Titan can go for. I definitely like it a lot on him. It gives him some mana back. Also a good setup for the stomp, so you can just Yule someone and stomp as they come down. It's really hard to get out of that initiation. But I guess one Yule Scepter is enough. And the Vlad's helps the meme regime end the game a little bit quicker. And there's a headdress, I guess, building towards the mechanism soon. Don't really think that Peter's going to be able to get there anytime in the... probably in this game at all, to be quite honest. They should probably end the game before then. Anyway, not really too much happening here. I don't know if this is a best of three or not. I don't really know what this stage they're in. I think it should be playoffs for them. Taking quite a while for him to reconnect. I guess sometimes internet is hard for people to have. I know that Mister is like playing from California or something. Something weird like that. What is he building? He's doing a Dragonlance. Also, Amazon is dumb. I've had like 4 different packages in the past week that they could not like deliver in a timely fashion. That's ridiculous. Like, Amazon is, like, ridiculous. I'm sick of their shit. Wow, Zingle is an ass. Anyway, we should be ready to go back once again. I think these guys are pretty salty, though. Like, everybody here. Not just one team. They just all, like, pretty freaking salty. Bunch of salty kids, man. Just a bunch of salty lads playing Dota. And the meme machine, they're not even grouping up right now. They're just in so many different lanes pushing them because they don't really seem to care right now. Like, it's so easy for Passion to die here. In terms of vision, yeah, it's pretty easy for them to see that. Just rushing up the lane. Now, Skin is going to hit for the Dire, so they will see a couple of heroes there. Mid's going to push in a little bit, pretty naturally, with the super creeps in that lane. Yeah, so the meme regime, they just go over the top. Not sure how much that Wiener Mash is going to be able to do to combat this. I mean, Draw Ranger can hit it from the low ground. Weaver can hit it with the Desolator. What is... Okay, Big Gigantic's taking a lot of damage here. Also a lot of mana away from him. The Sunstrike is going to hit. And oh no! Just his shield left as he got fingered to death at mid. And no buyback for him. He's down for 48 seconds. Ben's going to take a while to get back into this fight, and they're going to have to do the fight without them. Lion, he blinks over, and oh, the meatball gets dropped down on the Wiener and Trey Palantir, which is going to have to back away from this. It's going to be an immediate buyback from the Disruptor. He needs to get a good ult off. They're going to throw out the Chain Frost, and Zeus is here with the Veil of Discord as well. Now, which is his ultimate went over to the creeps. It's going to hit around a couple of heroes some more, but just so much damage from Zingle. Mister goes forward. I don't even think that's... he cares about Sly Fox's poor damage at this point. He will heal up within inside the base, and, well, that's going to be GG. Kim Jong-il puts down a couple of items, and, yeah, he's just BMing a little bit right now. Apparently, they're really tilted, but Invoker goes into the base and will Yule himself. Anyway, that is the first game going to the meme regime. They will take game one over... Treehead's Wiener Mash. And there really isn't too much to say about that one, even though they are really not that great of players, the meme regime. They're able to ride the backs of, I guess, some good support play, and maybe Zingle being on a broken hero, and they still manage to win. So we'll be in game number two in just a few moments, guys. Stick around and mash those wieners, I guess.